Kunthi. Kunthi was the daughter of Sura and the sister of Vasudeva, father of Shri Krishna. Her name was Prida. She was brought up by Kunthi Bhoja, who was childless, and so she was called Kunthi. She was by nature very pious and a great devotee of the Lord. While she was being brought up in the palace of Kunthi Bhoja, she had the great fortune of serving sage Durvasa for a number of months when he chose to camp there. Kunthi was very young at that time, yet she discharged her service quite well, and it was the only exceptional case where Durvasa was much pleased by the service rendered to him by any person. He was a very irritable personage, easily losing temper and cursing others for trivial faults, and himself suffered a lot in consequence. In this case, he was much pleased, and as a mark of gratitude, he gave the girl a mantra by repeating which she could request any god to give her a child. No sooner had the sage gone, she wanted to test the mantra and repeated it in the praise of the sun. The sun came to her in human form and offered her a son. She was very much afraid and tried to refuse, as she was not yet married, and told the sun that she merely wanted to test the mantra. But the son said that she will have a son without losing her virginity, and a son was born to her through the year. So the child was later called Karna. Kunthi kept the birth a secret, put the baby in a box and left it on the Ganges. A childless fisherman got the box, found the child to his surprise, thought that God has fulfilled his longing, and so brought up the child. Kunthi was married to Pandu, who was then ruling Hastinapura. He married another wife called Madri. Kunthi had three sons, Yudhishthira, Bhima and Arjuna. Madri had Nakula and Sahadeva. Pandu died very early and Madri gave up her life with him. Kunthi was left alone to protect the five sons. After Pandu died, the blind Dhritarashtra sat on the throne. He brought up his 100 sons and the five Pandavas equally. But soon envy started. The Pandavas were, by foul means, turned away from the kingdom. Kunthi followed the children and protected them. They escaped from the Lac Palace before it was set fire to and travelled in the jungles. On the way, a female demon called Hidimbi fell in love with Bhima and had a son by name Ghatotkacha, who was very useful later in the war. While they were living in Ekachakrapura, Bhima killed the demon called Bakasura and saved not only their hosts but the whole town from death. In their next camp, they were at Panchala. Arjuna won by contest Draupadi as wife. But when the Pandavas reached their camp, Kunthi was informed from outside that they got a very good fruit that day. She asked them, all five brothers, to share the fruit equally. So, as per her wish, all the Pandavas married Draupadi. When Dhritarashtra heard of the Pandavas and their marriage at Panchala, he called them back and gave them half the kingdom, and they were ruling from Indrastapura, Patna. Kunthi lived with them till the Pandavas lost their kingdom in a dice match. And later she remained in Dhritarashtra's palace. When the war ended, Sri Krishna approached her and asked her if she would have any blessing from him. She began to praise him and said, "Let me and my sons be always having some difficulties. Because of these troubles, we have been able to remember you and are worshipping you. We are receiving your kindness abundantly. If we have no troubles, we would just forget you, and there would be a great separation between us and you." And further, "Atha visvesha vishvatman vishvamurte svakeshu me snehapasha mimam chinti dhritum pandushu vrishnishu tvai me ananya vishaya mati madupate asakri trati mudvataha tada gange vauha mudanvati." Then, O Lord of the universe, the universal heart appearing in the form of the universe. Sever the strong bonds that bind me with my own sons and the Vrishni family where I was born. Let my mind unfaltered rest in thee. Let my thoughts flow on to you as the Ganges flow to the ocean. When Dhritarashtra, Gandhari and Vidura left for their last journey, Kunti also accompanied them and left her mortal coil doing tapas in the Himalayan forests.